First reading is written in Acts chapter 4, verse 13 to 21. Acts chapter 4, verse 13 to 21. Now, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and realized that they were uneducated and ordinary men, they were amazed and recognized them as companions of Jesus. When they saw the man who had been cured standing beside them, they had nothing to say in their opposition. So they ordered them to leave the council while they were discussing the matter with one another. They said, "What will you do with them? For it is obvious to all who live in Jerusalem that a notable sign has been done through them. We cannot deny it, but to keep it from spreading further among the people, let us warn them to speak no more to anyone in this name." So that they called them and ordered them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered them, "Whether it is right in God's sight to listen to you rather than to God, you must know." Or judge, for we cannot keep from speaking about what we have seen and heard. After threatening them again, they let them go, finding no way to punish them because of the people, for they all of them praised God for what had happened. Hear the readings of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalms 118, verse 1 to 4, then 22 to 29. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, "His steadfast love endures forever." Let the house of Aaron say, "His steadfast love endures forever." Let those who fear the Lord say, "His steadfast love endures forever." The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is Lord, and he has given us light, bind the festal procession with branches, up the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will exalt you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be, world without end.
Continue standing for the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in Mark chapter 16, verse 9 to 15. Now, after he rose early on the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons. She went out and told those who had been with him while they were mourning and weeping. But when they heard that he was alive and had been seen by her, they would not believe it. After this, he appeared in another form to two of them as they were walking into the country. And they went back and told the rest, but they did not believe them. Later, he appeared to the 11 themselves as they were sitting at the table, and he abandoned them for their lack of faith and stubbornness, because they had not believed those who saw him after he had risen. And he said to them, "Go into all the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord.
We may take our seats. Let us pray. Indeed, Heavenly Father, we know that you can, that we may have life and have it in abundance. And we know that whenever that had an encounter with you, their lives were no longer the same. And today I pray in the name of Jesus that have your word, because your word alone has got power but to transform our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Beloved, those who are watching us, wherever you are watching us from, and the congregation here at the Cathedral of the Holy Cross, today, allow me to speak to you with the theme that I've entitled, "You cannot have an encounter with Jesus and remain the same." You cannot have an encounter with Jesus and remain the same. And I will draw your attention from the first reading that we have read, where we see the life of Peter and John. And this story, if we are to follow it, it's coming from Acts chapter 3, when we hear that Peter prayed for the man who was born lame. And then it happened that when that man was healed, and in verse 4, that's where we hear that the Pharisees and the scribes were amazed, and they even warned them not to speak anything concerning Jesus of Nazareth. Beloved in the Lord, Peter, he was a fisherman with his brother Andrew and their partners, James and John. They were the fishermen, that was their trade. And in a religious context, it probably has a more limited meaning of not trained in the law. They were specialized in fishing. And even the Pharisees and the scribes, when they saw a remarkable and a miracle that happened, that a man who was lame was being healed, they were very amazed. But there's one thing which is very remarkable, because after realizing that these men were just ordinary men, they were fishermen, but they noted one thing, that they were following someone by the name of Jesus Christ. So in other words, one not formally trained as the scribes or the Pharisees. Peter and John, they were not theologians, but they were fishermen. So, knowing that Peter and John were untrained, the teachers of the law were amazed at what they did, because they knew that this man, there is something that has made them to do what they have done. When they saw their courage and they realized that they were unschooled, beloved in the Lord, a change of life convinces people of a Christ's power in our lives. One of our greatest testimony is the difference that others see in our lives. They noted one thing, that they were fishermen. But when they were with Jesus, something extraordinary happened upon their lives. And no wonder, even when it happened, the scribes and the Jews, they were amazed, because they say that this cannot happen unless that Jesus who was with them. So, beloved in the Lord, in this scenario, or in this case, even when they were told to stop to preach the good news, they had the strength and they had the courage, because they knew, they did not only knew, but they saw and they heard what Jesus taught them. So it is impossible for us not to speak about what we have seen and what we have heard. Even in this period of coronavirus, what is it that we have seen and what is it that we have heard? Yes, we have seen people die. We have seen people that they are in quarantine. We have even seen people that they are suffering from the disease. But there is one thing that we need to know. We need to hear something from the Lord. That's what can give us the courage and the hope that we want. The first thing that strikes in Acts chapter 4, verse 13 to 21, is that the transformation which took place to the disciples. And hence, when you have an encounter with the Lord, there is something that happens upon our lives. You can believe, you can trust, you can believe with me today that even you who is called a Christian today, there is something that happened to your life. And that is evident, because people today can testify and say that this man was not like this. But the moment he accepts Jesus, the moment he followed Jesus, his life changed. Beloved, there is no one that can take away that which we have received from God upon our lives. Because it is something that you have seen. It is something that you have experienced. It is something that you have heard. And no wonder, even in the midst of this difficult pandemic called coronavirus, we need to hear from God. When we hear from Him, we are going to be encouraged. Yes, even when we hear, when we announce it to the world, even to the people that we'll be interacting with, they are not going to believe at first. It didn't start to you, it went to the disciples. When even in the gospel that we have read, when Mary Magdalene said to the people that Jesus is arisen, they never believed her. Even today, as long as it is the Lord, as long as it is something that you have heard from God, whether people believe it or not, it is something that is going to have its way in the life of the people and in the world at large. Therefore, the source from which Peter and John drove their boldness was that they were with Jesus. They saw Jesus healing the lame. They saw Jesus preaching to the multitude. And when, even when they were told that don't speak anything about Jesus, they denied, because they knew that Jesus is their Messiah. They even risked their lives, because they knew that there is no one who can save us, it's only Jesus Christ. Therefore, a disciple of someone is not where he stands in the moment of comfort, but where he stands at the times of challenge and opposition. Even us today as Christians, we have been struck by coronavirus. And the fact that we have been struck by coronavirus, people are going to see that which we hate and that which we experience upon our lives when we confess our faith to the world and assuring them that this can only be done or this can only be dealt by Jesus Christ whom we believe in. That's what the world is waiting to hear from us. It is not a moment for us to begin to mourn. It is not a time for us to begin to weep. It is a time for us to begin to give hope to those who are hopeless. And as we are giving hope to those who are hopeless, we need to know that they are not going to believe us. But nevertheless, we must not stop by giving the hope to the people. Because Jesus, he passed on the baton unto the disciples. And the disciples, they passed on the baton. And no wonder today, we can able to say with the boldness that Jesus is the only one that can save us. Therefore, you cannot have an encounter with Jesus and your life remain the same. Because when you have an encounter with him, there's something that changes upon your life. And that it is evident because the people are going to give a testimony that this man or this lady, she or he was not like this. But the moment he had an encounter with Jesus, his life or her life today, we can give a testimony. Then, healing a man was that they realized that this is the only thing that can even make them even to believe in Jesus Christ. To be with Jesus, meaning we are going to have no fear. Even when troubles comes upon our lives, we are going to have an inner voice within us which is going to help us to stand firm that even this situation we are passing through, it is going to pass because we know that Jesus is on our side. They gave the evidence that they had seen him. They have been with him. They hate him and they were concerned that he was the Messiah. Even us today, what is it that we are hearing even in the midst of the coronavirus? Because the world is watching, even our children are watching. Whatever things that we are confessing, that's the baton that we are going to pass on even unto our children. Because whatever things that we pass on to them, they're going to pass on even to another generation. Even in this period, as we have been struck by the coronavirus, my prayer and my desire is that may God Almighty, may he give us the boldness and the courage like he did when he gave to the disciples who stood by the truth. They stood that no matter the opposition, they stood even no matter the challenge that they were challenged. They were warned, even as they were warned, it was something which everyone in the society, they saw what happened. That this man whom they have made to receive, that they have made for him to be healed, he was a man who was lame, and everyone knew it. And they saw it because that man was lame. Even as today, the corona is real. The corona is real, but we know that there's someone who can help us to stop or to make end to the coronavirus. And his name is Jesus Christ. And no wonder even today, as we are going to be still refocusing about what Jesus did on the cross of Calvary, the moment we have an encounter, we are going to become and we're going to be, and there shall be an extraordinary things upon our lives. Peter and John, they were unschooled because the Pharisees, they were even amazed because they said that these are fishermen. When God wants to do something, it doesn't matter the level or the background of your education. But I'm not saying that education is a bad thing. It is good because when we are educated and enlightened, we are going to do things logically and we're going to do things according to the will of God. So education is good, it's not bad, but what we need to know is that whether you are educated or you're not educated, when you have an encounter with the Lord, there is a transformation that happens upon your life. Therefore, my prayer and my desire is that may God help us so that we may have that inner transformation upon our lives, even as we are in this midst of the coronavirus. May God bless you, because God wants to reassure us and He wants to restore that joy that was lost. In Jesus' mighty name.
Praises, O Lord,
assure them that you are with them. Remembering, O God, even those that have been affected, O God, in different ways, socially, economically, every way that this epidemic, Lord, has affected us. Lord, we arrange such people that, Lord, you come through for them. Father, praying for the leadership of the nations. We pray for the leadership of Zambia, the President Edgar Lungu, his cabinet, all those in authority, and every leader, that, Lord, even as they lead the nation through this phase, grant them the courage, grant them the strength, grant them the wisdom, Lord. Father, even they too, as they are deeply troubled at the well-being of their citizens, of us, the citizens, we pray, Lord, that you grant them direction. Heavenly Father, we pray for the leadership of the church. We pray for Archbishop Justin Weyber, the Bishop, Archbishop of Canterbury. We remember the Archbishop of our province, our church. We remember the Bishop of this diocese, David Njovu. Remember the Dean of this cathedral, Charlie Thomas and all clergy. Father, and remembering every clergy, that Lord, even as we continue to shepherd thy flock, Father, we pray for your grace, especially in this phase, O God. And Father, we will continue to journey on with the people that you alone has entrusted us with. So Father, we seek for the wisdom and the grace, even in this phase, O God. And even as a community, as families, as we have many questions, many queries, Lord, we ask for your intervention. We ask for your intervention, Lord. Father, we pray for this parish, we pray for everything and everyone connected to this parish. We remember the programs, even every other activity that is connected to this parish, that Lord, you continue to meet us at our very point of needs. Remembering each and every family, that King of Glory continue to watch over them. May your light of God continue to shine over the congregants. May your face of God continue to go before. This we pray, King of Glory. Father, remembering even those of God that are ill, those that are unwell, those that are troubled in various ways and various areas of their lives. Father, we stand with them in prayer, seeking you, O God, standing in the gap on their behalf, that Lord, indeed, O God, you meet them at their point of quest and their point of need, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we continue to pray for all those that are celebrating life, all those that are celebrating their birthdays in the parish. That, Lord, you continue to guide them, you continue to grant them grace, and that, Lord, you alone will continue to watch over them, that they may fulfill their purpose here on earth as you have purposed it, O God. So, Heavenly Father, continue to pray, thanking you for the week that you have guided us through. As we continue to pray, even for the week ahead, that, Lord, in your grace, you continue to carry us through. And in a moment, let us offer our petitions before the Lord. Raise a request before the Lord. As you remember to pray for someone, you remember to pray for that dear friend, for that dear brother or sister, that dear parent, as you stand in the gap for another, as you remember to pray for a specific area that the Lord has laid on your heart to pray for.
Viewers, we continue our service. As Christ has taught us, we are about to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thou be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The bread which we share, is it not the sharing of the blood of Christ? We who are many are one body, for we all partake of one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. We do not presume to come to this your table, mercy, Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to run up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us mercy, O gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and him in us. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for us, and his blood which he shed for us. Let us feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Keeping us by your grace in the blood of your Son, the companion of all faithful people, help us to persevere through pandemic as living members of that holy fellowship, to be our brother's keeper through social distancing, and to grow in love and obedience according to your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as the nation of Zion, as a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out into the world as we make socio-economic sacrifice during these difficult times in the power of the Holy Spirit, to live and to work to your praise and glory. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen. Those that are going back home and those that are remaining, wherever you are, we say, may you remain in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thank you so much. Here marks the end of our Eucharist service for today. We'll continue again tomorrow, Sunday, same time.